We're talking now about business startup. Paul, you've run a business yourself. What's it like?
Martin, it's really hard work. I mean, you've no idea how hard it is. It's a 24/7 commitment that you make. And you do get phoned up at 3 in the morning when somebody breaks into the offices. It is very, very hard work. You've got to be totally, totally committed. And I'd really therefore say that it's not for everybody. If you like the security of a monthly paycheck, if you like that check to pay the mortgage, then this isn't the sort of thing that you want to do.
For those people that do, how can they find a business idea?
Oh, many people just have that eureka moment, and wow, it comes out of the blue to them, that this idea is something for them. But actually, I do believe that you can look for a business idea in a more systematic way. It is about scanning the horizon. It is about understanding the local market that you're in and seeing whether there's an opportunity for that idea within that local market. And I think one of the things I've tried to do with the new edition of the book is to pull together that systematic process of scanning the horizon and spotting business opportunity. I think I've pulled that together in a better way than in previous editions.
And if there was one major shortcoming of the majority of business ideas, what would it be?
Oh, that's very easy. Most people who fail in business have got a product or service focus rather than a market focus. By that I mean they love to do whatever is involved in the business, but actually they don't like selling the product or the service. They don't understand the customers. They don't understand the marketplace. So very simple answer to that one. It's a product rather than a customer focus.
And if you did have three main tips for growing a business, what would they be?
Well, following on from the previous answer, first tip, think customer. You've really got to understand who your customer is. You've really got to understand why they are buying from you as opposed to other competitors. You've really got to understand how you can convince them to buy even more from you. So first point, think customer. Second point, plan ahead. Leave nothing to chance because chance will happen to you. So as much as you plan ahead, you'll be prepared for the things that that come and hit you in the face. So always plan ahead. Prepare that business plan. And remember, the process of planning is far more important than the plan itself. So think customer, plan ahead. And then the final point, don't run out of cash. Most businesses fail because they run out of cash. Bills are paid by cash, they're not paid by profit. And, well, the number of businesses that I've seen that haven't understood the difference between profit and cash flow are enormous, and they're usually businesses